Hi guys, and welcome back to the Load Development Series, and today we're doing bullet length. The objective is to play with the bullet length in order to reduce the group size. If you are joining us for the first time, thank you very much for joining us. If you want to look at the rest of the series videos, I'll put a link in the right top screen for you, and it'll take you to some of the videos. If you're coming back to step 5 after watching step 1 to 4, thank you very much. I appreciate your support. So guys, as I said, bullet length we are doing to reduce the group size. Fortunately for me, on this Sarco 306 that I've been doing the load development series on, after doing step 1 to 4, I was able to shoot a sub-MOA group on this specific rifle. And guys, for a hunting rifle, that is more than sufficient. So I'm not going to be doing the length test on this specific rifle, and I'll take you to some of the past length tests that I've done on my 6.5 Creedmoor and my 223 and show you the results of the process. So first of all, the process is taking the load or the bullet length that you got in step 1 and the speed node and the speed that you got from step number 4, and combine that and start reducing the bullet length to shoot groups of 3 bullets per group on different lengths to see what it does. So there is 4 or 5 different lengths that people refer to on the internet. Me personally, I have done 3/1000ths of an inch shorter and 5/1000ths of an inch shorter on each of the bullets. I've done the 5/1000ths on the 223 and I've done the 3/1000ths on the 6.5, and on both of those I have phenomenal results whichever way you want to go. So when we talk about the 5/1000ths or the 3/1000ths of an inch shorter, I use the base to ogive meter. So I don't know if you can see that, but at the bottom of my vernier over here, I've got a base plate with an insert that measures to the shoulder of the bullet instead of to the tip. I don't know if you've seen it in your reloading experience, that the bullets, the tips actually vary in length. So if you want to go do a bullet length test and you have varying bullet tip lengths, then you kind of defeat the purpose. So for this, the bullet length test, I would advise you to get a base to ogive meter, a measurement or a measurement equipment with the correct insert. You can get them from Hornady. It's a whole pack of all the collets that you need. This specific one is from Sudami, and I've been using Sudamis since I started doing base to ogive measurements. So that is kind of a crucial part for this, as the bullet tips aren't always uniform and the lengths differ there already. So if you don't know about the bullet to ogive, hit me up in the comments. I'll quickly give you a brief explanation on how it works, and then you can take it from there. So basically, I've done it both ways. You can make the bullet shorter, and then what I've done with the 223, just as a test, I made the bullet shorter by 4 or 5 mils and then went longer to see what the difference is. So if we're going to do it the way that everybody else does it, we're going to go from the bullet length that we got from the gun. In this specific case, on the 306, it was 84.48 millimeters, and then we're going to start reducing that from there. Whether you decide to go 3/1000ths of an inch or 5/1000ths of an inch, it is your choice. Both will yield results. One might take a little bit more shooting than the other, so maybe take 5, maybe 7/1000ths of an inch shorter per bullet or per length, and then test it on that. So the way I've been doing it, I choose from my start length, and then I load 3 bullets per length, and then I go down from there. And I have used 5/1000ths of an inch, and I've also used 3/1000ths of an inch. Let's, for argument's sake, say that we're going to talk about 5/1000ths of an inch, as it also will yield results. So from your start, you'll reduce, from the start length, you'll go 3 bullets. You'll load 3 bullets on the data that you got from the steps previously in this series, and then you'll go 5/1000ths of an inch shorter and load 3 bullets again, and then 5/1000ths of an inch shorter and 3 bullets again, and so on and so on. What you want to do is you want us to, and you could do 5 shots if you're keen on doing 5 shots per length, you're keen to do that. I have seen that 3 does give me enough results to start to use that and go from there. So I'm going to just use the front page over here. This was done on my 6.5, as I am not doing it on the 306. I'm just going to use this as an example. So over here you can see bullet, I shot the first group, second, third, and fourth, going down to fifth and sixth. And even on the 2-3, I've only done 6 groups. I don't know why 6 is where I stop, but you could do 6-10, depends on what the results are. So for both of these, before I even knew what the results was going to do, I loaded 6 groups, which equates to 18 shots, because it's 3 times each group. So on the first one, in the 6.5, I started, and by chance this was just the best group, I started on the length, then I went 3,000 shorter, and it was pretty much the same. I had a little bit of a flyer there, and then again 3,000 of an inch shorter. So between target 1 and 3, I have pretty good results on the grouping size. If you look at group number 4 and group number 5, you can see it's opening up to much more than an MOA. So there might still be an MOA, and over here it's definitely more than an MOA. Then at group number 6, it started getting smaller again, and if I continued shooting, it probably would get smaller again, up to a point being the same as the first one. But this is what you want to see. And then the important thing is, what do you do with the information that you got from here? So if we look purely on this example, between group 1, 2, and 3, it's fairly good. If I load 1, and I don't know what's to the left of this, if I go any longer, this, it's difficult to exactly load 2 point, and this is based based to ogive measurement, 2.202 every time on my press. It's extremely difficult to load it exactly the same for 100 bullets every time. So I like to build a tolerance in it for myself. Between 1 and 3, I have good groups, so I'll go somewhere in the middle. So the start was 2.202 and group number 3 was 2.196. So I'll choose a bullet length somewhere in the middle of that, which should give me a good group either which way. If we look at the 223, so this was the same test. I just did it in reverse. I actually started out very small with the bullet and I went longer, closer to the lands. So group 1 again, good group, 2 good. Then look at group 3. It opens up, 4 opens up, 5 opens up, 6 it starts closing again. So I shoot the 223 with these same bullets. I shoot the 55 grain VMAX, and I actually went, building in that tolerance for myself, I went exactly in the middle of this, and I've been shooting that for the last 800 rounds, and it actually works out perfectly fine. So this is the results. If you look at the results that you'd get if you shoot the length test, it's going to be a good group, and then it's going to start opening up because it's not enjoying that length. It might be the harmonics changing it. And then all of a sudden at the end of opening up, it starts closing again. So this is the ideal picture that you want. It's a small group and it opens up and it closes again. All right, so this is, as I said, this is the ideal one. It's a small group and it opens up and then it goes smaller again. And then you just choose somewhere between 2 good groups. You choose a length in the middle. And that is how you determine your bullet length at the end of the day, because that'll give you consistently small groups on the length. Because you've done step 1, where you determine the original length. You've done the speed node, so the gun likes the speed, and you're just fine-tuning the group, well, the bullet length, to get a better group. So guys, that is the way we do the bullet length test. I hope that this helps. If there's anything that you're unsure about, please hit me up in the comments. I'll answer all the questions that you've got. If you have any suggestions, please feel free to get me up in the comments and we'll take it from there. Guys, thank you for the support. Thanks for sticking around. Thanks for watching the series and doing the series with me. I hope that you yield results at the end of all of this. And if you have yielded results, please comment either on my social media or here on YouTube and give me some feedback on how it went. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks, guys, and we'll see you for the next one.